Hi. Yes. I am listening to the trial. I don't know if you can hear it in the background. I keep it on in the background. Blah, 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 blah. I just can't pay them full attention all these hours. So, excuse me, burp. I keep it on in the background while I, well, while I work on a translation project. I finished one yesterday. No, is today Wednesday? I finished it day before yesterday, on Monday. Yesterday I began the binge of trial. Oh, man. Oh, man. I finally gave up and went to bed. So I missed the big fight late at night. They said they had a fight. Well, I mean, they said nasty things. They went, oh, you're such a Senate. Oh, you're such an uncouth House representative. We are Siamese, if you please. We are Siamese, if you don't please. So, I've been listening to it today. I went to bed early last night. I just couldn't take anymore. I had to go lie down. I was so burnt. And then I slept nice, and I woke up. Got up and I made coffee and I came out and I worked on the next translation project. The one I finished Monday was only the urgent one. Now we got one, I got about 10 days. No, before the end of the month, I got about a week I can work on this one. And I spent some time sorting things and putting them in boxes over in the other room, over there, that way. Where this, you might see the sun, see it? It's trying to shine, but it's not quite there yet. It's still a little bit south, but the air is clearer today. And so there's a little bit of light coming in towards the end of the day. It'll be sunset in a few minutes. I look out the other window over here, which looks west, and I can see all the houses and trees lit up with the sun. It's pretty. We've had some cloudy days. It's been very depressing. Cloudy skies are depressing, yes. We Californians are famous for, oh my God, we didn't see the sun for a day and a half. Oh, it's terrible. I'm going to kill myself. Or, oh, the temperature's 50-something, it's freezing. 50 means freezing. We Californians. Yeah, well, I'm still chewing on what am I going to do, because I now have 10 days left in this month. And then there's the next month that I'll be moving stuff I want to keep. I'll be moving it into storage. And I pretty much decided that after February 29th, I'll go spend some time both camping when the weather's good, to see if I really like it, and also spending some days at my brother's house, a little ways north of here, about 90 miles north of here, along the edge of the mountains, just west of the mountains. So I'll go up there and back out to the desert. There are different roads to the desert, not just one. There are many roads to the Rome of the desert. Yes. And I'll go up to his house. They're moving out, and they need a little help moving stuff. And I'll be using my car, which is a big old wagon, 1999. It's built by Toyota, but the brand is Lexus. It's basically the Toyota. Which is good, because if I go to Mexico, there's all kinds of people everywhere who know Toyotas. Yeah, I'll be able to get some help. Anyhow, I'm not going to Mexico yet. Mm-mm. I'm just dreaming about it. First, I'll be staying in California, helping my brother move. And then, after March and April, end of April, they're done moving. After that, I don't have any really firm things until the end of June. So a month and a half later, 2 months later, I want to be in L.A. for my son's convention of choir, harmony, barbershop choir singing. But before then, I might be going into Baja to check out some of these rental places. I'm still utterly nuts over this one place. It's 10,000 pesos, which is about 500 and some dollars a month. But it's huge. It's 4 bedrooms, which is good because my family is always complaining, how are we going to come to see you? Well, there'll be, and there's furniture. 2 of the bedrooms have beds and dressers, and there's table in the dining room and chairs, and there's a refrigerator and a stove in the kitchen. And I just can't believe this place. There's got to be something wrong with it. For only 500 and something dollars for a big old house like that, there's something wrong. Now, it's not that much below the rate, because it's not at the beach. A place like this at the beach would be $2,000 a month. But instead, it's a quarter of that. It's not at the beach. It's in a nice little town, right on the main highway, so there's no trouble getting there, even if the car doesn't work. It's 2 blocks from the main highway where the buses all go by. The buses to Tijuana, even. However, it will probably be rented very quickly because it's a good deal, and good deals don't last long. They get snapped up like that. Bam, bam, bam. And so, since I'm not going to want to move until after I'm done helping my brother, because if I go there, I have to stay there. I won't have to, but I want to. I don't like burning lots of money on gas. There's lots of camping around there. But there's a house that I could call my own. I could live in for less than this place. Because here I don't pay rent. I just pay the gas and electric and the water. The water's included in this house. I'd have to pay 500 and something dollars a month for this big house with a beautiful backyard and a bone dry, empty. I hope it's bone dry. If there's rotten water in that pool, I'm not moving there. It has to be either dry or dry. There's a pool in the backyard. A Mexican pool. So it doesn't have a heater and a chlorinator and a pump and a cleaner and a filter and all that attached. No. This is just a tank. But it's underground. It's made out of cement. I'd be afraid to fill it. I'm afraid it would leak. But no matter. It's out there. There's a great barbecue built in back there with a sink and a place where you can chop up your fish and clean your fish. Big counter space next to the barbecue. The asador. Outdoor. You can have your carne asada. Because you know that word, it doesn't just mean burnt meat. It also means barbecue party. You know the word barbecue in English, it doesn't just mean food, it also means a party. And carne asada also means a party. Not just the meat that's cooked at the party, but the party itself. It's a barbecue. Come on over, we're having a barbecue and we'll have all kinds of sweet tea and all that. So, and of course, remember I speak pretty good Spanish, so I won't have much problem getting by. And there are stores nearby, good priced stores. But I don't want to move there now. I won't want to move until May at the earliest, which means somebody else will rent it. Because it's only January now. February, March, April, that's 4 months from now. No, someone's going to take it before then. Unless it's haunted. Ooh. No, don't even. No heebie-jeebies. No. Anyhow, I don't know what the story is. Maybe it's in a flood zone. It's close. It's close to a flood zone. And if you look on Google Earth on the highway, you can see mud. On the street that goes to the house, you can see mud. There's a puddle there. And the house is just a little beyond in the part that's just a little drier. But just the same. That could be one reason why it's not $2,000 a month. Or even $800. A house like that, it's not at the beach, so it can't get that high-priced gringo price. But the pictures make it look good, but of course they're pictures from real estate. It's real estate porn. Come on. It's beautiful. It's sexy. It's a great house. I want to go there right now. Show off my teeth. A few I have left. Ew, they're yellow. Oh, man. I got to get my teeth cleaned. If I ever want to impress the Mexicans, I have to get my teeth cleaned.